Recently, Abstergo Historical Research began several new projects in London. We both know that when Abstergo makes big moves, the Templars are up to something. We think they're hot on the trail of a new piece of Eden. I've got people in London looking for it.
Hey, Bishop! Jacob and Evie Fry are twins. How awesome is that?
Speak of the devil. Fire up your cameras, Beck.
I've got picture. ETA on the payload.
Sending it now.
A lot to sift through. I'm gonna get the initiates on it ASAP.
You look weird with a weapon.
Let's plant a little bug and see what we can see.
Got something.
Isabel Ardant has a meeting here in a few hours. Doesn't say with who.
Doesn't say with whom, Rebecca. I suppose it's down to Muggins here to find out.
Hold on. The mission was to find data to locate a piece of Eden in London.
We did.
And now, I am eager to try this new kit.
I don't like it when those two go off book like this. Well, all we can do is take a deep breath and move forward. You'll be searching for the piece of Eden through the lives of Jacob and Evie Fry, twin assassins who operated in Victorian London. Your first set of genetic memories are downloaded. Good luck.
Brother George, it is as I feared. London has fallen. Thrice I've written to you begging your aid. Thrice you've responded with silence. And yet I write again. So desperate my need, so few my options. I need you. London needs you. You would say it is too great of a task, or that it is not yet time to strike. Patience, you would counsel. But whilst you wait, the Templars consolidate their power. They have chosen a Grand Master so ruthless, so thorough, one might think Reginald Birch himself had returned. His name is Crawford Starrick, and he intends to rule the world. There is no aspect of society he does not control, no industry that escapes his grim touch. By day, it is corrupt merchants and venal politicians who hold court. Come night, a vicious street gang known as the Blighters strikes terror in the hearts of all. There is no business untainted by his poison, no person unexploited, be it by duplicity or force. Our enemy has designs on the highest office of them all. And so, as you look inward, and dare I say it, afraid, Crawford Starrick's ambition is fixed on the beyond, to kingdoms and continents as yet unconquered. Though not for long, for he knows. As I have warned you time and time again, whosoever controls London controls the world.
The iron ship's from here. The Templar running things is Rupert Ferris and our target one. Target two is Sir David Brewster, who's got his hands on a bauble that could ruin us in this wretched war. Think you both can handle it?
What a question.
All right, my mistake. Ladies and gentlemen, the unstoppable Fry twins. See them nightly at Covent Garden.
George, honestly, I've studied the plans of the laboratory and have every route covered.
And I've got all I need. Right here. I'll extend your regards to Ferris.
Chat later, George. We've a train to catch.
Jacob! Evie! May the Creed guide you, you vagrants!
Poor man. More afraid than ever. Years have not been kind.
Evie Fry, where do you get it from?
The same place as you, Jacob. Don't
It's disrupting the other workers. Get the machine fixed. And send me some laudanum for my head.
Coming right up.
Goes in or out, unless there's a problem.
I'm warning you! keep it up and you'll be shot right here in our...
Come on! Rip your tongue out! Try his head off!
Afternoon, couldn't shut you up any more than I could get you off the brandy.
Oh, I do like some good distance.
Get to work!
Mr. Ferris, sir, the lad in the factory should be taken to be bandaged by the apothecary.
Fine, but dock his wages.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
one take.
It is done.
Oh? What did you accomplish, boy?
A vault loosened in Starek's machine. A large bolt. But not enough.
Your Grandmaster will fall.
You assassins can circle London to your heart's content. The mechanism we have built has been going strong for 100 years and will run 1,000 more. It is the very city itself.
We will take London from your hands.
From Croydon? You lurk in the shadows like a coward. I doubt it.
Thank you. seem to have made an unscheduled stop.
Prince's Laboratory. This is where the Peace of Eden will be located. No loose ends. Now, did a couple of locomotive and create a diversion.
Well, where is it? Huh? Where's Brewster's supplies? Meter. Busy while I head into your lab.
Follow me down the tracks.
You stay here and keep a lookout.
All right.
I'll shout if I get any bother.
First for a bird's eye view. Can't be too careful.
Weeks with the device.
Your questionable practices are beginning to draw unwanted attention. You've been given more than enough time to achieve results, Sir David.
I was unaware that you expected me to perform like a cocker spaniel.
Permit me to remind you of your obligation to the Order.
Miss Thorne, you ride me like a racehorse.
Sir David, I will return tomorrow. If you have not unlocked the device's secrets, forget your dogs and horses. I will leave you to the wolves. Good day.
I was merely promised a tour of the premises, my lords.
Who sent you?
One of Green spies.
Get that man to interrogation! Then I want him brought to the lab.
What a pity. But no deviations from the mission. Secret laboratory. Well, well. Perhaps I can aid this interrogation.
Take them to advance.
Thank you kindly. I was never such a squeaky fix when, what do you know? You rescue me.
Where's the hidden laboratory?
Untie me, and then we can parley, my lady.
I'm pressed for time. Tell me now.
It's underground. Requires a key. One of the guards nicked mine, cheeky sod.
Thank you.
Now, untie me?
You got yourself in. I trust you can get yourself out again.
Not to worry, my lady. Can still recall a couple of tricks from me carnival days.
Charming.
Jason Bear!
Have your guts for garters. Let's have a butcher's downstairs then. I want to see that artifact.
Not if you value your life.
Hey, leave them rats alone. They've as much right to be here as you.
Mind your own post. I'll feed them to me cat.
She should be here!
Got it.
Someone get up!
What have you done?
You're all right, pal.
Stop that thief!
Funny way to act, but still.
There you are. The entrance to Bruce's lab.
Johnny, you can't do it.
Too much to drink, eh, miss?
Of Eden.
Increase the electricity.
But it'll become unstable, sir.
You heard what Miss Thorne said. We need results now.
Time to lay down your head, Sir David Brewster.
But I have so much more to discover.
Do not be afraid.
I'm not. God will protect me.
I will continue your experiment.
You will not stop, Sarek. Miss Thorne has already found another piece of Eden, more powerful than the last.
I will take that one too.
We fight to gain what we cannot take with us. In our nature.
far too close. I must find a way out.
What was that explosion?
What explosion?
EV?
Piece of Eden detonated and took the lab with it.
The magic lump of hyperbolic metal. I'm shocked.
Simply because you have never valued the pieces does not
all
mean...
went according to plan,
There was a slight complication.
How slight?
The lab exploded.
Jacob.
You derailed a train.
Oh, he did. Did he?
Well, the train derailed, and I happened to be on it. I killed my target.
Brewster is also no more.
Then all in all, a successful mission, in spite of you two.
What about London?
What about it?
We're wasting our time out here.
You know as well as I do that London has been the domain of the Templars for the last 100 years. They are far too strong yet. Patience.
But the Templars have found a new piece of Eden.
Sir David is dead. They do not know how to use it. The Council shall guide us. Sound advice that your father would have seconded. I shall see you back in Crawley.
Patience, Evie.
Ah, the gentle sound of opportunity passing us by.
So what's stopping us? London is waiting to be liberated. Forget Crawley.
Father would have wanted us to listen.
Oh, Father. You could continue his legacy in London.
Freeing future generations from a city ruled by Templars. You know, Jacob Fry, you might just be right.
Then shall we?
Yes. Let's. Onward to London.
Sean and Rebecca. I still think attacking a Templar is a mistake.
Call Dr. Grammatica.
Come on. Oh, Isabel, what a lovely surprise.
Our mutual friends will be here shortly to search for the artifact. Once it's located, I'll let you know.
Super. Always a pleasure.
Prick.
It's people like you that give historians a bad name.
I'm afraid I don't have time for you today, Mr. Hastings.
Thank you for making my job easy.
Oh, shit.
It does look grim.
Master Berg, Agent Acosta. Deal with them, please.
Move it! Hunt them down!
All they had to do was wait for you to search the data. Their little stunt has put the whole operation at risk. You need to synchronize Jacob and Evie's memories. Find something that puts us ahead of the enemy. Time is of the essence, and lives are now clearly on the line. Good luck.
I've never seen so many people all at once.
Churning seas of London. It's just the way Father described. Now, to find Henry Green and formulate a plan of attack against the Templars.
Who's Mr. Green again?
The assassin watching over London. Did you not listen the first three times?
Listen to what?
Oi, watch it.
Ben Pine, sir.
Oi! Come back here, you filthy dipper! Keep it.
Well, well. What do we have here? You're on our property.
I'll gush your life out of here.
I see it.
Oh, don't pull any punches.
What else does London have to offer?
Now is not the time for tourism, Jacob. Now's the time to find Henry Green. I've always been the quicker climber, haven't I?
Not since we were two.
It happened right in front of me! Murder! Murder!
None of my
watch! What are these about?
Shop located. It was marked on Father's map.
Two assassins. Equal in height. One female, one male. 2 decades old. And those devilish smiles. You must be the Fry twins.
And you are?
Henry Green, at your service. I was sorry to learn about your father's passing.
Thank you.
What can you tell us about Crawford Starrick?
I suppose the Council desires news.
London must be freed to provide a better future for all of its citizens.
Well, thank goodness the Council saw reason and sent you to aid us.
Yes. Thank goodness.
Unfortunately, I am the bearer of bad news. Today, Starrick sits at the helm of the most sophisticated Templar infrastructure known in the Western world. Every class, every borough, the gangs, the industries. His reach extends all across London.
I've always thought of myself as a gang leader. Firm, but fair. Huh. Well, I have uniforms. And I'll unite a mix of disenfranchised outsiders under one name. That's it, Evie. We can rally them to our side.
Oh, like the way that you rallied those card players at the Oakbrook Tavern into the river.
Oh, that was different. They beat me at whist. I can see it now. We'll call ourselves the Rooks.
You're never good at chess either.
Have you got a better plan?
Find the Peace of Eden.
Oh.
Well, let me show you the lay of the land. Shall we?
The best way to see any landscape is from above.
Look at what Starrick has done to the city. Whitechapel is riddled with crime. Child labor, despite regulations. A gang known as the Blighters overruns the streets. And Templars manipulating behind the scenes. As in all the other boroughs, we need to return this city to the people who built it in the first place.
We will free London from Starrick. You have my word.
And my looks.
Miss Fry, your passion is inspiring. Come. Let us return to my shop, and I can bring you up to date on the rest.
One of Starrick's gang leaders.
Why does he want you?
He's after some of my more arcane research into one of the precursor artifacts.
The Peace of Eden.
So tell me about these Blighters.
In search of an army, Starrick gathered up the nastiest of the underworld. Some of the city's gangs tried to prevent it and were slaughtered for their efforts. Now, only Whitechapel's
Well, let's shine these clinkers up then, shall we? They're just the sort we're looking for.
You can't be serious.
Evie, they're ready to fight and oppose the Blighters. This is my chance to step in. Look out, London. Here come the Rooks.
This city, no one looks where they're going.
Yes, I've noticed that.
Bloody Drood, I'll never finish it at this rate. Only Providence knows where those words are headed now. Well, I must get to work replacing them. Should you ever be in the mood for a tale or two, you can always find me where the ale is warm and tempers are hot. Ta-ta!
What an odd man.
That Mr. Fry was Charles Dickens. Knows everyone and everything in the city. If I were you, I would keep that connection in your back pocket.
Kaelok's gang is nearby. They must not follow me back to my shop.
We'll take care of it.
Yeah. You might be able to use this.
Oh god, I hope so.
My carriage is nearby. Make use of it to throw them off my trail. I will meet you at the curio shop.
That's the way.
We need to lead them away from Greece.
Here comes trouble.
Their carriages are easily damaged. Kaelok will rule the day.
That's the fella. Here I come!
To return to Mr. Green.
Aye, aye, Captain.
You're relentless.
That relentlessness will see me become master when we finish this.
George would do nothing of the sort. Whatever's left of the Creed would perish under your control.
Harsh words, dear sister.
I do hope Mr. Green made it back safely.
Don't tell me you fancy the bloke already.
And what do you suggest we do if our number one source of information turns up dead?
Starry can't be that hard to find. I say we turn the carriage round and go find him.
This is why you aren't in charge.
Did you give them the slip?
We gave them more than that.
Who are all these people?
Over the years, I have established a number of connections across the city.
Splendid. We'll need focused aid.
Focused aid? We take over Starrick's gangs, we cripple his control.
You're not aiming high enough. Starrick has influence in every branch of society. We need to match him.
I see what you're saying, Evie. We need the Rooks.
You are not starting a gang called the Rooks.
I believe I may have an idea of my own. We will need the police to turn a blind eye to our activities.
My ally in the Force, Sergeant Aberline. I've heard he's a master of disguise. Next up, urchins.
Urchins?
Urchins. Jordra make for excellent spies.
Clara O'Day.
Smart as a whip, that one. Finally, you would be wise to remember that Starrick never acts alone. There are gang leaders in every borough. You'll meet them soon enough, no doubt. Rexford Gaylock, known for his ability to vanish before your very eyes.
Should we make him vanish for real?
I suppose.
One moment. A Templar target you might want to look into. Be cautious. It's rough out there.
No, don't worry about me, Greenie. I can handle a few thugs.
What's the plan, then, oh mighty planner?
You're the one with the grand ideas. The Gan. fights, even the outfits you'll wear. Perhaps you should lead the way.
If you insist. Must be up to something.
Don't see Mr. Abelard.
Well, we tried.
I may know a thing or two about that splendid fellow you're talking about.
What's this?
God's sake! Are you trying to blow the gaff?
What? Sergeant Abelard, at your service. I presume you're the Fry twins Green mentioned.
I was expecting you to be a policeman.
I was expecting you to be discreet.
Henry Green said that you could help us go unnoticed.
This is how it will work. I will give you the names of criminal gang members. You will bring them back to me. Quietly.
Oh, we'll be as quiet as an old lady. A very hairy, strange old lady that looks a lot like a policeman.
To remain within the bounds of the law, for my sake. I don't need any corpses at the station. Approach the target from behind and attempt to make them talk. Then bring them to my carriage, carefully.
you to medical college yet.
He's an old VI, dude.
Shit! I can take him now! Oh, shit!
Collecting rent from people who don't owe you a shilling.
Found it! Looks like a mess.
Ha! Somebody stop this kid!
I'll cut your tongue out!
Just get away!
Thought you could get away with that, did you?
Oh, for God's sake!
What's happening over there?
I wonder if anyone's been killed.
Amateurish. There's been a murder!
There's some sort of scuffle over there.
I see it! Oh, bloody hell!
Thought you could get away with that, did you?
Oh, for God's sake!
You could get away with that, did you?
Oh, for God's sake!
That don't look good.
What's that? Looks exciting.
Ha! Somebody stop! Oh, bloody hell!
Thought you could get away with that, did you?
Oh, for God's sake!
I wonder if he understands that.
Dead as a doornail.
How many crates do we have left to distribute?
Only about a dozen, sir.
Excellent. Soon all of London's blighters will be armed to the
teeth.
No bobbies in sight.
Good. Distribute the diamond.
Oh, blimey!
Dark
Try to get away from me! You won't work!
Must be one of the clinkers. Good place to start. Must be one of the clinkers. Good place
Someone
to start.
Fled Lambeth Asylum. strange performance artist.
Must be one of the clinkers. Good place to start.
Seem to want my employer's attention, Mr. Fry.
Oh, I positively crave it. But you'll do for now.
As you like.
Should do something about that.
If the police don't take the body, the rats will.
This brute's met a nasty end.
You won't be stirring up no more trouble.
What is this place?
It's nice to meet you both at last. This is Babylon Alley. Here we make it our business to know the streets and provide children with the opportunity to control their own destinies.
Clara, Mr. Green said we might be able to help one another.
In exchange for our services, we ask a small favor.
Well, why not? You seem to have taken most of my money. Why not take a small favor, too?
There are several factories about the city that are powered almost entirely by child labor. Those children work long hours with little pay, and most are not permitted even to leave the factory grounds. They suffer terribly. I need you to save them.
A small favor.
In return, we offer you intelligence, something you clearly need.
Oh, hold on a minute.
I'm late for an appointment. What are these terms?
We accept.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Chatter and more work. Next one to utter a word, spend the night chained to the fence.
I'm here to help.
You saved us! He's a stranger on a known mistake.
You're dead!
Oh. 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 stand in for you.
I'm right here.
Much appreciated, mister.
Does he know people can see him?
Next week, and we are forever home, shit.
What the hell was that?
Keep working! We ship out next week, and we are forever home, shit!
Well, bugger me!
He looks like a bloody idiot to me.
Keep quiet. I'm here to help.
Thanks, mister.
We can do this all day.
Stories. Trail's getting cold. Coppers are on it.
Something's out there. Stay out of this if you don't
actually know who did this.
Grab him! Drag him out!
Look alive!
More than ever.
You!
I'm
your
heart.
Oh.
Show him how it's done.
Kill me.
You'll pay for that. I've made a huge mistake.
What is it that you think I've done?
Collecting rent from people who don't owe you a shilling.
Yeah, me and half the richies in this bloody city. You gonna kidnap... Oh, bloody hell!
You got guns, I'll give you that! Hit him!
Somebody stop this kid!
We'll go hard on you! Somebody get him!
Somewhere else right bloody now.
Collecting rent from people who don't owe you a shilling.
Yeah, me and half the richies in this bloody city. You gonna kidnap... Ha! Johnny, stop this git!
Why do all the argy-bargies are there?
Today's your lucky day.
What's going on? Someone's up to no good. What's happening here?
Who's a good horse? You are. That's a girl. Walk on, girl.
See him behind bars. Thank you.
Come on, Daniel.
Give me the news.
They opened a new pie shop on Fleet Street. Brave move considering what happened the last one.
Yeah. You fancy some fun?
Lead on.
Hey! Look where you're going, you
diddy! Slow down!
Doing fine, girl.
Easy, girl.
Ah, there you are. All that stands between you and Whitechapel is the villain controlling the borough. Kalok has demanded you settle the claim for territory in a gang fight.
His loss?
Yeah. I'm sure he can put this to better use than I can.
Oh, what's this, Greeny? Assassin Christmas.
Gather your allies.
Thank you.
Mr. Rexford Kalock has agreed to your terms and waits for you at the Whitechapel train station. He's bet his train on the fight.
No Kalock. No matter.
Attack!
Whitechapel is no longer in the hands of the Blighters.
You now have the chance to join our ranks. We welcome all who would stand up to Starrick and his cutthroats.
to the rocks.
Ah, you bastard. I'd rather throw myself to the tracks than run Bertha another mile for that dirty ball bag.
Kaylock? He's left the station.
Mel! Hello, fancy pants. And who might you
I'm Evie Fry, and this is my brother, Jacob Fry.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Agnes McBean.
A delight.
I thought I was getting a promotion. I suppose I'm out of work now.
Come work for us instead.
I won't bile your heat. You pay better than scraps?
Oh, I'm sure we can at least match that.
Then may I present to you Agnes and Bertha, lady and locomotive, at your service. I'll be in the next car.
A hideout on the rails? What an excellent idea.
Yes, it all worked out rather well. Now, I would like to follow up a lead on... Jacob? Is this serious?
I'm not doing anything until this gets fixed.
I believe I know someone who can help with that.
I knew you would, Greeny.
You know, a mite of money goes a mickle bit in this city. Think of the power of good you can do with the purse you bring. You talk of a store in London. Well, now's your chance. That there map shows who to speak to. Old friends, if you will. Give him a whiff of that sterling, and maybe you can save us all from having to lay down our knife and fork afore we're ready. Now, enough shop talk. I believe Mr. Green said there was someone he wanted you to meet.
Thank you.
is a good horse. You are. That's a girl. Oh, blast them.
Alec, whatever is the matter?
I have been intercepting nothing but poppycock propaganda about soothing syrup and whatnot. No, I swear to high heavens, if Starek's monopoly continues...
Alec, I beg your pardon. These are friends of mine. Evie Fry and her brother, Jacob.
Alexander Graham Bell.
Linguist, inventor, and technical expert. Alec, I have something of a favor to ask you.
Can you fix this?
Oh, looks like the casing is cracked. Oh, comes apart. I see. Could have used one of these to fit my fuses on top of Big Ben.
Alec is installing a new telegraph line for our Free Press Association.
To combat the Starek Telegraph Company. Now, if I can mend the fuses connecting independent lines from Big Ben, Starek will be weakened. Only, we are somewhat at a handicap. And, there. Oh, I've removed the mechanism, so it may work with your bracer.
I'll put it to use immediately.
Jacob, wait. Mr. Bell, allow me to help you with your fuses.
Oh, you will not find me too proud to accept Miss Fry. Oh, we can use my carriage, if you'd be so good as to hold the reins, though.
I'll take that.
I can help you.
Miss Fry, I am so glad you could assist me.
So, Mr. Bell, what inventions are you concocting?
I intend to develop a phonetic telegraph that does not just convey dots and dashes, Miss Fry, but the human voice.
Phonetic telegraph? Sounds a bit of a mouthful. You could just call it a telephone.
Telephone? How bizarre. Anyway, as I was saying earlier, the press has become entirely dependent on the Starek Telegraph Company.
Which is why Mr. Green has asked you to set up a free line.
Yes. What is more, other small independent companies have had their lines sabotaged, and they have little means of finding any broken fuses, which are...
to be found on top of Big Ben.
Correct. Especially as one needs a special government pass to get through the guards.
They will not be a problem. I'll repair the fuses. Lovely view.
all set. Should do it. Thank you.
man was seen.
Why must your wife leave?
Thank you very much, Miss Fry. I will now be able to continue with the installation of the new line.
If there's anything else I can do to help.
Certainly. Please do come and visit. I was toying with this device and have noted down the formula for you. It's not perfect yet, but by golly, it works.
Come on!
than walking and talking.
Wouldn't I come over and teach you a lesson?
Miss Fry, I was just showing Jacob the first message was received via the mended lines. Oh, you can keep the rope launcher, by the way. We've managed to procure another one for your brother. Excellent work. Thank you again.
You're very welcome, Mr. Bell.
We can now defend the principle of impartial news and free speech.
Free is fair, but free and brief is far better.
Ha ha! Ah, Fry, such caustic wit.
And on that note, we must depart.
good fortune to you both. Call on me at any time.
Now that we've finished with that distraction...
Who is that?
Oh, you mean... you don't know?
Beautiful train you got here. Miss McBean was just telling me all about her. Name's Ned.
How do you do?
I won't take up more of your time. If you want to learn a thing or two about the finest transit systems in the world, you can find me at this address.
Let us return to locating the Peace of Eden.
We need to reclaim London from Starrick. Who are my targets?
It's not time for that yet.
I didn't come to London to hunt curios.
First understand the dance, only then become the dancer.
Oh, so you're taking over where Father left off.
Someone has to.
Evie, finding the precursor artifact will give us an insight into what the Templars intend. Jacob, I have information about Starrick's associates that should be of use to you. Here. Healing syrup has become the only medicine available in Lambeth. It bears the Templar Grandmaster's name.
About time for a visit to the doctor.
I don't see that cure arriving anytime soon.
And what exactly will you be doing, might I ask?
You know very well. Tracking down the Peace of Eden.
Enjoy your studies. I'll be out killing Templars.
Hard times, have you, friend?
Lady, I am trying to make my living.
My husband thought this panacea of yours would...
Get Staric soothing syrup right here!
It's all he drinks. Your syrup is liquefying him. He's turning him simple-headed.
You are scaring away my customers. Why don't you bugger off, or I'll give you something to remember me by.
You can't talk to me like that, you little gutterling.
What's all this then?
Oh, sod off!
If you'll excuse me, madam. It's so pretty, isn't it?
hell do you want?
Stupid knack! I'll eat your eyes!
Tell me where the syrup originates.
All I know is they make a run each day between the gasometers and the asylum.
She'll be done selling what we've left tonight.
Come over here!
You'll get a shipment Darling! Darling!
How are you today? The man in charge of the syrup distribution runs a fighting club at the Foundry.
What's going on?
Come back again, by all means.
What's going on?
Thank you.
To look hard to spot him there.
Where is the syrup, mate? Speak now or forever hold your...
The distillery. It's the large building beside the brewery.
Now, to stop soothing syrup production once and for all.
ready on.
Jacob, Miss Fry, how good to see you. Oh, have you seen Starlik's latest lies?
Lies in a newspaper?
What transpired from the new line you're establishing?
Oh, the cables we ordered never arrived. And then we intercepted this. A message mentioning cargo seized at College Wharf.
Then let's unseize it.
Oh, wait. Another intercepted wire contained the recipe for a powerful hallucinogenic serum. I've adapted this dart mechanism to work with your bracers.
Alec, you're a genius.
Well, that patently is untrue. Although I've also discovered that the serum adopts a form of a gas when subjected to heat.
Just when I think you can't surpass yourself.
Shall we?
when ready.
Count on me.
Open fire! Moonlight's trespassing!
Like that time for you, Pete.
I can hit him from here! Stop him! Serves you bloody well, right?
Take him out. How are things?
Ready for a round? How about you?
Thank you.
someone! It's right there!
Know what kind.
Mr. Bell.
Every worthwhile endeavor is fraught with dangers, my dear friends. None more so than yours. But you have triumphed once again.
How do you know?
We have entered the age of communication, remember? We've already received word from Greenwich that the shipment has arrived safely, thanks to you.
Have you discovered what else is in that shipment?
Indeed. I'm afraid that Starrick's poison has found its way onto the open market.
If he believes that will stop us, he is mistaken.
driving, not me like.
Keep a sharp eye out, lads. Someone's targeting our network. The distillery might be next.
This will complicate things.
I wonder what he's up to.
Is there something going on?
Let's not get near him.
Thank you.
not go about frightening respectable gentlemen, young man.
I didn't realize snooping around was considered gentlemanly.
Snooping? Sir, I assure you.
Keep vigilant.
Quick, inside. That was too close a call. You, young man, gave me quite a fright. I thought you were one of them. But I realize now why you're here. Same reason I am, I imagine.
I imagine?
I believe I found something, young man.
Rather impressive contraption, wouldn't you say? I've seen bigger.
Tura Stramonium, or Devil's Snare as it is commonly called, that goes into the syrup, an opium, no less. Revolting. Absolutely sickening. A favorable way to proceed, wouldn't you agree? Quickly! What about the other valves?
Take a wild guess.
Very well enough.
What's he doing here? You'll be sorry.
checkpoint. Well done. Charles Darwin, delighted to make your acquaintance.
Jacob Fry, the pleasure's all mine.
While you were busy wreaking havoc, I found this. It indicates that a sample of every batch has been sent to Lambeth Asylum.
I wonder if it's visiting hours.
Don't be so hasty, Mr. Fry. Many people work at Lambeth. You wouldn't want to attract unwanted attention.
What was the fun in that?
Not every problem can be solved by blowing things sky high. Sometimes a little discretion is in order. It's getting late. I will meet you at the asylum to continue our investigations.